Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Lion Plays, the Binding of Isaac. Last run, what can we even say? First floor, fate. Second floor, mom's knife. It just gets more ridiculous after that point. We're gonna start a new run and we're gonna random. I should probably move on to hard mode first, but let me revel in this for a little bit. Samson. I have played a Samson run fairly recently, but I like Samson, so I think we'll do it, and we'll do it not even a cheesy way. Like, I won't even try to walk into this item room to see what it is before doing it here. 46EX, Y0BB. Y0, baby, when I think you're a 10. Well, I was like, should we re-roll it? I'm starting to fall into that, like, vanilla trap already. It's like, you know, what should I have for dinner tonight? Well, you only got, you know, sandwich meat and bread in your house. Are you gonna wrap the meat in the bread, or are you gonna wrap the bread in the meat? There's really only two ways to go about this. Trickle charge is a good item. What's my strategy gonna be as Samson? Well, my strategy as Samson is gonna be kick the crap out of the game. Preferably, we'll get an IV bag as soon as possible, and that gives us a very good baseline for how shitty our run can be. And I mean shitty in like it can't get shittier, because IV bag is like not that good of an item, but we can always choose when to swap IV bag out with something that's better. On the last time we had a Samson run, the IV bag ended up being an item that we carried with us pretty much to the end game, because it gave us a huge damage bonus at the start of every floor. We also had a lot of HP, and, you know, we had a lot of things working in our favor in that run in general, but IV bag Samson is like, it's the kind of combination, I wouldn't necessarily call it default, but you can pretty much get an IV bag on every run, assuming that you can snag an arcade or just a random blood bank at some point, and you got the balls necessary to gamble as deep as you need to go. Hopefully we can make that happen on this run as well. Otherwise, we're kind of subject to the whims of the items as they show up. I would not be offended to pick up a satanic Bible, or a red candle, or perhaps a head of Krampus, especially as we approach our own holiday season here. Evil plus range plus shot speed up. Not very good, but acceptable. I'm starting to come to the point where I'm starting to think about, like, boss room tier lists. This is going to be the end of our floor here, unfortunately. And I'm thinking that stuff like the safety clip, it's kind of like it's low, but on the first floor, you get a little bit of a buff for it, because it gives you that black heart, which gives you probably a better chance of actually getting a deal with the devil. So there's almost like a weird kind of segregation. Like, there's like a tier list, and then there's a tier list for the first floor boss room. Like Squeezy, I think it's pretty good overall, but Squeezy on your first floor boss room, it's not GG, but that gives you a leg up on the average competition, I'd say. I'm trying to think of anything else that's like that. The crate's kind of like that, you know? Maybe you don't have a key, and then you get one key from the crate plus, you know, you get like a starter pack, basically. You get a trinket, you get a pill, maybe a spirit heart, but definitely enough infrastructure to open the next item room you come across, if you're willing to save it, at least. Ooh, that was not an area I probably should have tried to get out of there. So yeah, I'm thinking about it. I'm not gonna do a video probably or anything like that anytime soon, but I do think it's interesting to think about, kind of, because, you know, you gotta set your priorities internally for stuff like rerolls, or you can just play it by feel, I guess, which is another valid way. I love piercing shots. Maybe this isn't quite as good as Sagittarius, because I think Sagittarius gives you some HP as well, but piercing shots, I love them in vanilla, and I love them in Rebirth as well. Makes your damage go so much further. Now, it doesn't nullify the effect of picking up brimstone, but it does mean that, you know, you get that kind of brimstone-ness without actually having to pick up brimstone. Now, if brimstone shows up, I'll probably still pick it up. Don't kid yourselves. And Monstro's Law in full effect here. You know what? I appreciate Monstro's Law coming back into effect, because for a while, we had fucking Haunt's Law. And Haunt's Law, which is a difficult word to say, it almost makes me feel like it's like a Romanian castle or something like that. But Haunt's Law, where you fight Haunt every second cellar, was a goddamn nightmare. Almost always take damage against the Haunt. The reason that I didn't take damage against the Haunt on the last fights, or the last run that we did, was because by that point I already had Mom's Knife, the ability to fly, and maybe even Pyro as well. In my defense, I don't think I had Mr. Mega yet, but still. So we're doing real well here. I should probably move a little bit further out of the way, but it's sorted. Deal with the Devil should be approaching here. Pageant Boy, we don't have a choice, so hopefully there's a nickel. There's not, but that's okay. Maybe enough money to make our shop worthwhile. And, Whore of Babylon, headless baby, ceremonial robes. Let's take all three. Because it'll be fun. I don't think there was a specific order in which we had to take all three. Wow, our tiers look so freaking cool. Is that because of Whore of Babylon? If so, that is amazing. I'm not going to go to our curse room now. Why Northern Lion? Why would you do something this ridiculously stupid? It's funny. Basically. I'm trying to figure out where I would even look for a secret room. I don't think it would be here, but I'm going to check here anyway. That didn't even get the pots. That might not have even triggered the secret room. Let's check our shop, because if there's a there's a spirit heart, which there is, I'd like to pick it up. Now, we won't be able to do our IV bag crazy shit anymore, because I've taken away all of our red hearts. That being said, I put us in permanent Whore of Babylon state. It probably won't last that way forever, you know? We're going to want to pick up some HP at some point, but we can enjoy it for now, at least. Curse of the Blind. I like this. Let's not even be able to see what our items are as they show up. Maybe we will roll, like, permanently Whore of Babylon and never pick up any HP. I don't think it's the wisest choice out there, but I also don't know what items we're going to have show up yet. And really, the reason, by the way, that I picked up... There was like a weird chain of events, basically. I was like, well, I'm going to pick up ceremonial robes. A chain of thoughts in my head, I should say. I was like, I'm going to pick up ceremonial robes. Is Headless Baby worth it? Probably not. Is Whore of Babylon worth it? Probably not. But if I pick up Headless Baby, is Whore of Babylon worth it? And the answer at that point becomes like almost definitely yes, because it becomes immediately active. So really the only way that those items were effective enough to pick up is if I picked them up all at the same time. I really think the only way to roll that Devil Room, I should say not the only, but the most strategically beneficial way to roll that item or that Devil Room was to roll either all of the items, none of the items, or just Ceremonial Robes. Because Ceremonial Robes also is, it's not advertised, but it is a damage upgrade as well. So it's kind of a no-brainer pickup. You know, you always want more damage. Oh, right. Magnet allows that to defy gravity. Lucky me. Well, Pyro. That's good. Curse of the Blind makes things a little tricky. I almost, in a way, I kind of hope we don't have a deal with the devil on this floor. Because I don't trust my level of self-control. Like, I think I will probably end up picking it up, and who knows what it could be. Could be great. Could be terrible. Those are the ways it could go. Look for secret rooms and second secret rooms, at least in areas where it's convenient. For me. This room's not so bad, thanks to penetrative tears. I'll wait. Don't sweat it. Any minute now. We'll move along. Okay, I am tempted to go to our curse room, but I said I wasn't tempted, that'd be a lie. But it has to be like in an area that's pretty accessible, and there aren't many like that, so I'm thinking it's either here or here. Alright, it is there. And it's a slot machine. You know what? I'll blow up the slot machine. After playing it once and getting my penny back. And that's given me enough money to actually make do with our shop here. And also enough keys to feel reasonably okay about doing something like this. Now, I wouldn't necessarily consider that a great trade, but that's okay. It's okay. If I were a second secret... Well, there's a couple of different locations where a second secret room could be. And unfortunately, and you gotta, like, line it up here. Like, here? I'll never know if that would have worked. Oh, good. Right. We can't even see. I bought Champion Belt. You know what? As far as blind items go in the shop, that's awesome for us. Champion Belt will give us more consumables and also gives us a damage upgrade. It's pretty good. Especially good against an enemy like Mega Fatty, who is otherwise pretty darn annoying. Now, it's not the best bomb I've ever placed in my my Isaac career, but we will use as many bombs as is conceivable to do. You know, we have 93 of them, and we're not doing quite as much damage as we were doing on the last run, so we might as well take advantage of anything we can. Forgot we can't actually shoot our bombs, we gotta bump into them. Is that my creep? I think that's my creep. Should stop wasting bombs here. He jumps every time. Oh, good. All right, so we got a range upgrade. Thank God. Okay, so fighting Krampus is actually great for us because it means we're gonna whatever we get, we're gonna get it for free. Fuck clips, you know. They said get it for cheap. Nah, we're gonna get it for free. And it, the other thing that's great about this, it's really a win-win situation. It doesn't matter if it's Krampus's head, which it is, or a lump of coal. Either of them would have been useful. So this is a totally fine situation, in my opinion. Down to the next floor. We've been to everything, and it didn't go too badly, to be honest with you. I think it went okay. On our next floor, Caves Part 2. No curses. Is this real life? We're actually doing pretty well for HP, but no means to which to continually grow our HP in the future. Yet. A relic, a miter, Book of Revelations, Satanic Bible. You may end up taking advantage of these, even though I do love Krampus's head. What can I say? Sometimes people think that I don't value Krampus's head as an item, but it's quite the opposite. It's because sometimes I say, like, oh, I would rather get Lump of Coal here. That's just to make my life easy, because it doesn't give me a decision. Lump of Coal shows up, you take it. Unless you have a reroll, in which case maybe you want to reroll it. But Krampus's head, if you have an existing spacebar item, you got to make decisions, right? Like I said, quite contrary to popular belief, I actually love Krampus's head. I think it's possibly the best offensive item in the game. For spacebars, at least. It's absurdly powerful. How could I say no to an item like that? Well, only if I had something else that maybe makes it a little bit more exciting. So now I would love to pick up anything that gives us the opportunity to use Krampus's head more often, but we do already have Trickle Charge, which basically allows us to use it once every two rooms, which is very strong. But if we actually picked up 9 Volt, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think we'd actually be able to use Krampus's head to, like, every room, which would be ridiculous. Old Bandage is actually one of the best HP upgrades we could possibly expect, because it doesn't actually fill our container up right away, which means as long as we avoid red hearts, we can actually have the benefits of having HP while also not having to suffer the loss of damage that we'll have. That was really, really bad. After we pick up some red hearts. In most situations. Hopefully that made sense. I was adjusting my headphones. They're kind of squeezing in on my ears a little bit, making the tiny little cartilaginous areas in there hurt. Lockdown. Not that big of a deal. Not good anymore, but not that big of a deal. Alright, so I'm expecting our shop to maybe give us a chance to buff up our spirit heartness. I did lose one by being an idiot, and half of one by taking damage. Whether or not that damage makes me an idiot is probably a little bit more of a question of your personal tastes, I guess. This is a very interesting run, though. Not nearly as overpowered as the last one, but still quite strong. I mean, I don't think we need BOGO bombs in this situation. We already have 83 bombs. I'd rather just save our money so we can use it maybe more effectively on the next floor. Maybe. I gotta say, I am loving our trickle charge here. This is one of the most effective, I think, trickle charges I've ever seen. There's not many trinkets that you could convince me to replace it with. In fact, I'm thinking of them right now, and I'm not liking what I'm coming across. Speed up. Acceptable. Not worth the damage we took, but it's okay. Please explode. Thank you. Yeah, there you go. Thank you for the pill as well. Ah, I like it. Okay, this is great, because we got the pyro bombs now. Or the fire bombs. Now all we need is, like, sad bombs to go along with this. We have 99 pyro bombs, which is pretty good. Liberty Cap is not good enough to replace what we got going on. No question about it. We're gonna blow up a decent amount of mushrooms, because we know that there's a health up pill in our rotation. Don't want to waste all of our bombs, but I don't mind wasting a few. Should look for some secret room action as well. I don't think it's likely to be below us, so I think it's going to be above us. Free money. I love having these empty red heart containers too. Second secret room I thought could have been there, but probably isn't, now that we actually look at it. So instead, you'll be looking at, like, this for a second secret room. Or this for a second secret room. Okay. Well, it's not like we have any shortage of bombs. Other locations? Last one, I think, is this one for a second secret room. All right. And we get some pills. Wow. So many, like, empty ones. Tears down. That sucks. 48-hour energy. We'll take it with us. That's actually a very good pill. It's just not really that useful for us at this late point on that floor. No tinted rocks. Okay, down to the next floor. Very interesting kind of conundrums we've got set up for ourselves here. The longer we go wait on this 48-hour energy, the better, by the way. I don't love that. I didn't think that anything had actually dropped there. So I was like, what's going on? What's going on? And then the tick just showed up. So that's a bit of a throw there. That's going to make Krampus's head a decent amount worse. Which, paired with that tears downgrade, makes me feel pretty bad. But actually, we might be able to pick up... the other thing about the tick is that it's going to give me automatic lifesteal, which kind of sucks. But the other thing that we can maybe have happen is Mom's Purse shows up on this floor. I really don't want to lose our Whore of Babylon impact, but it will happen sooner rather than later. Guppy's head, you know, that gives us a fairly reasonable chance of becoming Guppy if we get a deal with the devil on this floor. Oh, I picked up a bunch of HP there. I didn't see any hearts in there, if you'll forgive me for that. Hopefully we find a deal with the devil. Would I get rid of Krampus's head for an IV bag? No. No, I would not. But thanks for asking. Even once every three rooms, Krampus's head is still really good. And, you know, the tick, it shows up, right? I can't feel too... That's their creep. Okay. I can't feel too bad about it. Sometimes it just shows up. You gotta not plan for it, but at least not be too sad when it actually happens. If it actually happens. So our damage is gonna be very much diminished here. And as sad as that might make you, it's not that bad, because as Samson, at least we have an out. Not only do we have 79 bombs, which is a great out, we have 79 fire bombs, which is even better, and we have penetrative shots, which means that damage downgrade, it's not that bad, and we have the ability to get more damage if we can just hurt ourselves, and if we can hurt ourselves constructively, that's great. But sure, you know, I can understand it being a little bit of a negative we've got going on here. Shoop-de-whoop is not nearly worthy of replacing Krampus's head, even though you can use it a lot more often. That's obvious, though. Why am I crushing some of these rocks when I come back into the room? I actually am just a little confused about what is happening there. One thing's for sure, though, we could definitely use some offensive improvement here. There, that was a decent dodge. The masks actually helped me out there with that push, which I appreciate a lot. And the lower your damage gets, the more damage you're going to take, which is our problem here. Yeah, that's another 48-hour energy, which is great. We could use that constructively with something like Guppy's Paw, like we had. But I don't think there's that much value in that. Fanny Pack or Jar? We'll get the fanny pack, just because there's kind of nothing else stopping us. Let's go up to 5, well, we're up to 550 right now. I was going to see if maybe there was another shop upgrade that happened there, just, you know, roundish numbers. There was not. Oh, he did get me. Well, we don't need to go back there, we can just go to this room instead. Yeah, this is, losing what I had, like, losing Whore of Babylon... Losing Trickle Charge has actually put us in a, like, very much behind the eight ball here. Please, another Guppy item. Ah, a Spirit Heart is two Spirit Hearts, very worthwhile. Now, we will still pretty much 100% have a deal with the devil chance here. Already been to, we haven't been to our item room yet. Okay, there it is over there. We will still nearly 100% have a deal with the devil chance. That's really big for us. And if we can get two Guppy items, that could lower us to 1 HP while giving us the ability to fly as well as becoming Guppy. Lemon Mishap is just not nearly good enough for us right now. All right. This is a good run that I can't help but feel could be great if we just had the ability to reroll. But that's no excuse. You know, not every run is going to be like that last run. And we can't act like it would be. Loki. Speaking of which, I can't even complain that this run is difficult based on the fact that we're destroying enemies. Or bosses, at least, in one hit. But we'll be moving on. Because I'm a sucker, like I said, fucked up in the head, not... To reference, you know, the number one band of all time, Lamp Basket. My producer is telling me it's Limp Bizkit. That doesn't make any sense. I thought it was a basket which you put lamps into. You know, when you turn 50 years old, you get your first lamp basket. We're going to gamble a lot here. Because this gives us a damage bonus. It also gives us Fanny Pack. Well, it doesn't give us Fanny Pack, but it allows us to use Fanny Pack to pick up not an unlimited number, but a large amount of consumables, which allows us to get even more money out of this situation, not to mention we're getting into our Whore of Babylon state as well. Yes, I know there's an Eternal Heart there. I would, you know, perhaps preferably like to have this blood bank completely pay out before I worry about that Eternal Heart. That may or may not happen. Now, oh, I picked... God dang it. That being said, I've probably reached like the cap from Rage, or Bloody Lust, I should say, if Bloody Lust actually does cap out. And I think from my, you know, earlier play, I can assume that it does. Okay, that was just way too fast. I should not have gone that fast. And now that Whore Babylon's gone, we will have slightly lower damage, but actually definitely more damage than we had on the last floor. Maybe I would get rid of Krampus's head for IV bag. I don't know. The damage bonus is so nice. The tears down pills are not. And what also isn't is continually getting... Oh, shit. Oh, at least it isn't a brimstone one of those. What also isn't nice is consistently getting these item rooms that are just active items I don't want. But we're still alive, so I can't complain so hard. Oh, shouldn't have taken damage there. We have to fight greed at some point. I don't think I want anything here. Like, blank card, we might as well take this, I guess. Blank card could be fine, or it could be, like, basically meaningless, you know? I think it's going to be basically meaningless. Krampus' head is already great. Blank card doesn't work with 48-hour energy. How would that even work? They just consistently, like, reinforce each other. Puberty. Yeah, okay, I'll pay 15 cents to get one pill, and it's a tears downgrade. We're not sunk. Like, I know I'm talking a little bit despondently. I don't mean to necessarily. We got penetrative tears. That was really dumb. We got penetrative tears that do a decent amount of damage. We have 82 fire bombs. We got good upshot from, what am I thinking from? From Whore of Babylon, right? If we can ever make that happen. We've got one guppy item. A decent amount of, you know, like interstitial hearts, as I call them, or extrastitial. I don't know. This is the last one, right? Yeah, okay. Like, we have a pretty good chance of coming out of this run with a victory. Krampus's head, great spacebar item that's doing a ton of damage for us, but there are some things missing here. And there's no guarantee, well, there's never a guarantee, but there's certainly no guarantee here that we're gonna actually come out of this just fine, but let's fight Mom. She's already taken a decent amount of damage thanks to the tick, and then we're pretty much just gonna have to step in and finish the job here, which is gonna be very easy. Very easy fight, and we do not have, we're gonna take the Polaroid, of course. We do not have a boss rush. We're just about a minute too slow. Guppy items. Oh, man. That's tough luck. Kinda needed that room to be a little bit better than it actually was. Again, we're not sunk yet. We are not, HMS Lusitania. We're not the Titanic. I'm trying hard to think of other sunken vessels. We're not the Vasa. Maybe it's just called Vasa. I don't know. I don't propose to know that much about Swedish military history. Oh, okay, that's no good. That's also not so good. Can one of you just die? Like, my life gets a lot easier once I don't have to deal with so many of you. I think we do it. Eh. This floor is kind of a big one. I'm not gonna say we need anything, but let's talk about if we lived in a perfect world. If we lived in a perfect world, we would get a deal with the devil with two guppy items. One of them would be 9 lives. The other one doesn't necessarily matter that much. That was probably not a justifiable usage there. If we lived in a perfect world, we would be fighting a boss that's very easy for us to take out. Maybe like a Skolex or something like that. Or a Gertie Jr., although we can't fly. Or not Gertie Jr., Mama Gertie. We can't fly, so Mama Gertie might actually be a little bit more difficult than I give her credit for here. Chubb? Yeah. And that's pretty much it. The only other perfect world scenarios I can really concoct here are we make it to the chest and then, you know, maybe by the skin of our teeth, probably by the skin of our teeth, then we're able to pick up enough items to carry us, basically. Which is a story so old, I believe it was originally written... It's a trinket, right? We can't take it. Yeah. I believe it was originally written by Geoffrey Chaucer in the Canterbury Tales. He said, "Lo and the peasant did..." I don't know. I've never read the Canterbury Tales, clearly. "Lo, when the peasant did survive to the chest, and his scum ass was granted mom's knife." Hopefully, that story repeats itself for us right here. Really wish we still had Trickle Charge, man. Being able to use Krampus's head once every 2 rooms instead of once every 3 rooms makes a difference. That is not great. At least, you know, the one thing you can say about when you're Samson is that at least when you take damage, you get something out of it. But, alright, so this is going to be like a Mr. Fred situation or something like that. The double gate, okay. Well, pretty good start, I'd say. Give me a deal. That's all I can say. No deal. So we get a tears plus shot speed up. Man, that's not good enough. What are you trying to sell me here? Apparently batteries are not affected by the magnet. Is that true in real life? I don't think so. Anyway, down to the next floor. Decent Krampus's head charge can kill mom's heart. Or at least take her very close to death. We got our bombs to carry us through anything else that might be, you know, truly heinous. Always, like, the real struggle on this run... Oh, come on, don't do me dirty like this. The real struggle on this run... is going to be, to kill Isaac. There's 2 of them, right? Yeah. And if we kill Isaac... I think that we're basically set... to do something on the chest. At least we'll have a chance, because those are the next items we're going to generate, right? I mean, I shouldn't say we're basically set, but if we beat Isaac, we have a better chance of beating the chest than we did of beating the cathedral in the first place. That almost makes no sense, but I hope you know where I'm coming from there. Yeah, I kind of hemmed myself in there. Man, we could desperately use a wide variety of different amenities right now. I think that was worth it, even though I didn't finish the room. Oh man, give me some spirit hearts. Come on now. Well, this could allow us to reroll our whole run, maybe. Or it could just give us a dime. You know, pretty much 2 sides of the same coin there. Both extremely useful. One of them could purchase you 2 pieces of bubblegum at a store. The other one could save you from certain death. 48-hour energy is, again, such a great pill. Don't get me wrong here. If there's one thing that I haven't talked about this run doing for us that's actually been great, it's these 48-hour energy pills. Will it or won't it be enough? This is a room where it's deceptive, man. With penetrative shots, we have no reason to waste any of our precious resources fighting Chubb. Worth it. And again, if we can save... Like, the one way we might be able to do this pretty good is if we save this 48-hour energy pill and we use 2 to 4 Krampus's head charges against Isaac. Like, I don't know what I would do in that situation. I'd be like, well, someone up there really wants me dead, right? What are you gonna do? Can't do too much about that. Luckily, my range is better than your range. So yeah, I'm gonna try not to. It's gonna be hard to avoid the temptation, but I'm gonna try to not use my 48-hour energy pill against Mom's heart. Because if I avoid that, I think that gives me better chances in the future. I'm so happy that we didn't have to... That's their creep? Pardon me? I'm so happy that we didn't have to go through the big room. Alrighty then. Let's do it! I'm excited. So Mom's heart is already in a bad place. You know what? I'm gonna throw a bomb down here, even if it kills nothing. Because the fire against Mom's heart would probably be pretty okay for me, you know? Now get ready, because we are gonna suffer a damage downgrade. Okay, we are gonna suffer a damage downgrade when we get down to the next floor. This has gone okay, though. Remember, people are gonna be mad at me, because there's still people that ask this every single time, but there's no deal with the devil items in there. No red chest, no nothing. People always say, well, at least you could go check. Never, never has that situation happened. You see that little technique right there? Pretty sneaky, sis. Fire does decent damage. I should start to try to think of some more creative usages along those lines. Because you never know if that might end up saving me the 1 HP necessary to carry the run here. I'm a very lucky man. So I know we have that 48-hour... Oh, so bad. I know we have that 48-hour energy pill. Death card. Pretty nice here. I'm gonna try this. I like it. I like it. I know we could get the Whore of Babylon State by taking another one of these items, but what freaking item do I want to take out of that horse hockey? Thank God that wasn't Bad Trip. That would have killed me. I mean, Are You a Wizard sucks, but... This is for you, Dark Bomb. Dark Bomb, I love you. Dark Bomb, I need you. I really wanted to take... I don't want to take that Spirit Art yet. Could have easily walked over that. Oh, so good. I wanted to get down to a half heart, though. But everything we touch will kill us in one hit. So you know what? Let's not get too fancy here. Ooh, I actually like this decision a great deal. Probably should not have used a death card here. Can we fight Loki next or something? No, two monstros. Yeah, yeah! Jump into the fire, motherfuckers. Eat Shit and Die, my favorite R.L. Stein novel. Nice. Okay. Big plays. More spirit hearts. Alright, well, you can't always get what you want, I suppose. So now I gotta creep over, get this 48-hour energy pill. Pick up this, pick up that over there. Alrighty then. Big plays. Now there's always people that, you know, this happens. They say GG. GG, you got Dark Bomb, GG. We're far enough back on this run that, what am I thinking? That Dark Bomb is not a one run by itself. In fact, as you may be noticing, it's actually, oh my god, it's actually a fairly realistic chance we actually die in that room. I'm gonna take it. Sorry, Dark Bomb. I have to take it just so that we can actually have a chance to get to a half heart interval ourselves. Be smart. This is smart. Save your Krampus's head for the next room that's likely to be more difficult than this one. Good. Very good play. Smart play. I appreciate you. Thank you, Dark Bomb. Okay, maybe next time. That's all right. Now, we gotta fuck up Isaac. Get ready for what you have to do on that fight. Okay. You gotta, you gotta be cool, you gotta be cool, you gotta be cooler. I don't even... What? That's probably the song I've heard the most in my life that I just don't know what it is. I didn't own that many Women in Songs album as a kid. Or as an adult, for that matter. I'm not saying it's kids' music. We gotta get ready. Get ready to fuck up Isaac. How are we gonna fuck up Isaac? We're gonna use Krampus's head, but bam, that's a space bar. Then, immediately after, we are gonna say that we're gonna press the Q key. Don't let him hit you one more time. We're gonna hit the Q key. Oh, come on. Come on, dog. And after hitting the Q key, that will... Sounds like a cute name for a little cucumber familiar or something like that. Q-key. After we hit it, we're gonna get a full charge and at least one battery dropping. Possibly more. but we can only rely on the one showing up. And then we're just gonna mash the shit out of it while we have the chance. This is for you, Dark Bum. You gotta pay out, and yeah. You gotta pay out, you gotta pay, you gotta, oh. Well, these half hearts, man, they still benefit me. Puberty. This is a tricky situation. I think I already checked here, but I might as well check again. We got enough bombs that, I'd feel bad if we died with 50 bombs. That'd mean we didn't really give it all we had, right? Let's check out this area. One of these times we're gonna find a second secret room. If it is full of red hearts, that's Dark Bum's time to effing shine. Thank God we got that extra spirit heart back there. Thank God our shots are kind of wide. Oh, I love you, Dark Bum. Oh, they don't take damage from blue spikes anymore. That's news to me. Please, thank you. This is another, like, do as I say, not as I do situation. I didn't think it would be there, but I thought it... Oh, God! I thought it might be worth a try. This is another fucking crazy situation that I don't relish the thought of. Lucky me, I guess. Joker? Okay. So we take the Joker card. Right, we've already been here. Not that it would have helped us. It would have helped us on the chest, but we're taking 48-hour energy anyway. All right, get ready. You know the deal. Pop that. You want to get the whole value pack out of it if you can. Make sure he's in trouble the whole time. And we go, hi-ya. And he's very nearly dead already. Don't get too creative here, right? Like, we don't need to throw bombs in. I'm just throwing them down just in case that's where he chooses to spawn. And we're definitely going down to the chest here. This is for you, bum friend. All right, that's fine. All right, well, we could still pull out a victory here. It hasn't been easy, but here we are. Celtic Cross, a unicorn stump. Luckfoot, magic fingers. This is almost good enough, but not quite. Why don't I take unicorn stump? Because we can't do damage except via our headless baby. Why not take magic fingers? It's just not as good as Krampus' head, is it? So how do we win this run now? Really, just like a fuck ton of rooms with gluttonies on them? That way I can... Oh, well, we're gonna probably die right here. But a fuck ton of rooms with gluttonies on them. Get some rice that's very glutinous. Ah, we're dead. We tried, though, and I think we gave it a good shot. That's going to be a tough seed. If you did better out there, I'd love to hear it, like, sincerely. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the run. If you did, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. And, of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.